Hello and welcome to Back to the Future, the show where we talk about movies past, present, and future. Today we are talking about one of the newest movies to hit wide release finally, the new Western, Hostiles.
You have no idea what war does to a man.
Hostiles is directed by Scott Cooper, known for Out of the Furnace, Black Mass, and Crazy Heart, the film that Jeff Bridges got his Oscar on. This one being now a Western film by him, which I think, after seeing Out of the Furnace, definitely I think a good move for his sensibility and pacing. This is a very dark, slow-burn Western starring Christian Bale and Rosamund Pike, which I think those two in particular were the shining stars of this. Their acting was honestly, Rosamund Pike, I haven't seen that much of her. This is like my second real film with her. She's honestly amazing in this film, and honestly, as well as in Gone Girl, but this is another one that solidifies, she is really, really good.
Yeah, Rosamund Pike is definitely a standout in this. She was definitely a standout in Gone Girl as well. I think she dropped a lot of jaws in that movie. She was really good. Christian Bale plays a more subtle performance in this one. He's really good at doing both the range. You see what you see in American Psycho, his more out there stuff, but I think this one is definitely a little more restrained and more internalized and brought through his facial expressions and experience and whatever that, but great cast all around.
Yeah.
Just great performances. And Scott Cooper, I really personally enjoyed Out of the Furnace quite a bit. I wasn't a big fan of Black Mass, but I think that just suffered from a bad screenplay. Personally, and I haven't seen Crazy Heart yet. That's on my list of movies to get to, but this movie the opening sequence in this film is brutal.
Yeah, this movie has some very, it has explosive brutality. Like I said before, it's a slow burn movie, and it definitely feels it's over 2 hour length of time, but when the violence comes, though, it is brutal and harsh. It is a tough film in a lot of those ways. It's very dark in a lot of these ways because it's trying to show us these horrible things that are going on both sides of this situation. And really, that is kind of this whole film is really, like I said, it's showing both sides of this situation and both sides are the wrongdoings, and also that both sides are both people. You know, it shows the atrocities from both angles, and I think in that way, and the results that it has, and the effect that it has on both of these people, from the Native Americans and the soldiers and American citizens, or white settlers.
Yeah, I think a lot of the movie doesn't have necessarily, it doesn't have answers.
No.
Necessarily. That might frustrate certain viewers. There's not really necessarily a conclusion. It's just showing characters. It's showing people that went through these atrocities that existed during this time and had to make decisions either way. There's definitely brutality on both sides. It's just a really interesting line that the movie walks. I think Scott Cooper did a really good job of walking that line and kind of showing... Yeah, just the different aspects and just, it's a very tough movie to watch.
Yeah,
it's a very tough movie to watch.
Yeah, it's filled with these very, very dark moments. And right from the opening scene, like we said, it's like, whoa. it just kind of kicks the door down with that. And I think that, the thing that you mentioned about it, it really is just kind of showing these characters and how they're affected. And I think that that's the thing that one of the things I praise the most about this movie is that everybody's reactions and the way that they act, it all makes so much sense, and it's so human. Like, I think that, especially with Rosamund Pike and Christian Bale and Yellow Hawk and Black Hawk and their family, the reactions that happen there and, what these people feel about these things that have happened is very realistic, and I think that it makes this movie very human in that way. And I think a great idea for a theme for a Western.
Yeah, I think so. This is a movie, if you don't like Westerns, true Westerns, this is probably a movie that you're not going to enjoy at all. It is a slow burn. There are long scenes of very little dialogue or just not a lot of substance going on necessarily. Mm-hmm. That's flashy. I guess there is a lot of subtle substance going on, but personally, I really enjoyed those different elements. We don't get a lot of movies like this anymore. You know, when you see westerns come out, it's either, you know, like the Magnificent Seven remake, some of that action, or you get more of the neo-westerns every once in a while from Taylor Sheridan.
It's not like, you know, so much I love those movies.
With like Wind River and How High Water, but... you know, just seeing like a true Western like this, they just don't
promote. And honestly, a lot of ways, I'd rather buckle down for something like this. This is very interesting to me. It definitely feels its length, but I think Scott Cooper does another great thing that even though I felt like Out of the Furnace kind of had that same thing going on, I think that he does a great job of making the visuals step up to the plate.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this movie, I think, has got a lot of just great visuals and is a visual treat in a lot of really, really nice ways.
Yeah.
Well, I've obviously mentioned it a couple times. I think for me, the big, as far as the negatives in this film, I think for me, it's definitely its pacing. Though I think the slow burn really, really works, there's times when I felt the same way with Out of the Furnace. I felt that we slowed down sometimes or didn't show a few things that it would have been nice to have it within our runtime that we had. We had this long runtime. There was a few things that happened off camera that I would have kind of maybe liked to see happen on camera. I think they would have maybe made just a little bit more, I don't know, just a little bit more something visually and kind of just with this film, just a little bit more excitement.
I definitely agree with that. Pacing is one of those critiques I hate.
It's a weird
one. I hate giving out, and personally, I really liked Out of the Furnace.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed that. I didn't really have too many critiques for its pacing. That, for those of you who have seen that movie, it is a very slow-paced film as well. Mm-hmm. It's a long movie, and you feel its runtime for sure. Mm-hmm. They definitely could have trimmed up probably 20, 30 minutes even.
Mm-hmm.
Cut it down a little bit, and made it a little more clean cut and smooth. Other critiques for this film, you know, like we said, it leaves it up pretty open-ended,
mm-hmm.
The film. I think Scott could have had a little more, I think he could have brought a little more focus to it.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's kind of my general complaint for the film.
Yeah, it's kind of like he gives you gut punch, gut punch, gut punch, gut punch, but we don't really ever have any kind of pathos to them, you know what I mean,
yeah.
In those ways. Like, there is, and there's things to dig into, but I think that there's just something where the movie was leaving you wanting from in that respect.
Yeah, yeah. It's a tough one, but for me, that's kind of where it really did. Like, I love and dislike the open-endedness of it in some strange ways, because I do like seeing that. I like being able to leave some stuff up to the imagination, or... just kind of those subtle ideas on Christian Bale's expressions and stuff like that. But I feel like at the same time, it could have been a little more streamlined. I think he could have had a little more focus on exactly what he wanted to say with this movie instead of it being more shock.
Yeah.
Because I feel like in a lot of ways it's a little more shock. And it's not cheap, though.
No.
Like I think it's well done, but I think he could have just been a little more focused with it.
Yeah, so that's definitely... a lot of all my positives and my negatives for Hostiles. John, what is your final summary and grade for Hostiles?
Hostiles is a film I was looking forward to seeing when I first saw the trailer for it. Seeing Christian Bale in a Western, and I did enjoy Out of the Furnace, so I was excited to see this filmmaker come out and do a Western. You know, just general likes, dislikes. It's an interesting movie, and it's a time period in film that we just don't get to see a whole lot of. So, mm-hmm. I mean, from that aspect, if you're a fan of Westerns, I would definitely check it out. But keep in mind, it is very brutal. It's very hard to watch. I'm pretty desensitized, and it had me, like, breathe, like, just, oh, okay, hold on a second. I need to strap in here for this movie, but... like I said, negatives. I think the movie could have been a little more focused. It just wasn't quite that iconic Western that I thought it could have been. But I still think it's an enjoyable watch. If, like I said, if you like Westerns, check it out. I give Hostiles a B.
Yeah, I definitely echo John's sentiment about if you're a Western fan, definitely go out and check out Hostiles. I think you'll love its sensibility, its pace to it. But as we said, it is a dark, brutal movie. It's tough. You know, this isn't one, it's not like a popcorn flick. So be prepared for that. And just like as we were saying earlier with Out of the Furnace, it's definitely Scott Cooper has a certain pace to his films. This one is not any different. But I think it has enjoyable visuals, amazing acting, and a solid script and themes that are going on. But as we said before, I just feel like it just left you missing something from all of the things that happen, all the things it blindsides you with in this film. There was just a little bit more pathos, just a little bit more payoff maybe, that would have just worked for me just a little bit more. And as John kind of said, it just didn't quite reach the heights of like some of the best Westerns that I've ever seen. Not The Hotel, but the films. But it just doesn't quite reach it. But honestly, really, really solid. And as I said before, if you like true Westerns, I think you'll really dig this. And you know, a little subtle thing for me, when I first saw this was just seeing the promotional material. I just love the look of Christian Bale in that old, like, uniform. He looks great. He looks like the old pictures. Like, he looks like one of those guys. Yeah. So he just, I saw that, I was like, wow, that fits like a glove. I always really liked 310 to Yuma, so I was kind of like, oh, okay, cool. You know, Christian Bale doing another Western. So that was actually really made me gravitate toward it a little bit. I was like, wow, that looks really good with the costume and everything like that. Christian Bale and Western, definitely want to check it out. So guys, if you haven't checked out Hostiles, ooh, I almost forgot, I also give Hostiles a B. If you guys haven't checked out Hostiles, go ahead and check it out. I know this is definitely one that people aren't going to be rushing out to because of Westerns, but it's a really good one. So get out to the theater, give this one a little bit of love, and enjoy the great acting on display. You can find us on our Twitter at Back2Feature, and you can also find us on our Facebook at /Back2Feature. I've been Giovanni Carlo.
And I'm John Malou.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Something tells me you ain't got the nerve to fire that woman.